Hey, North Road, it's Matt, and it is Devo Day 4, and we are getting ready to kind of walk into that next step of the crucifixion of Jesus. We're getting ready to walk as he kind of gets ready to take that walk to the hill called Golgotha, and I want to walk into a really cool piece of scripture today that's going to really challenge us as Christians to really think about how we live our life in front of a lost world. Now, the scripture is found in Matthew chapter 27, and it's found in verse 27, and here's what it says. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters, and they gathered the whole battalion before Jesus. So I want you to kind of picture Jesus is brought in. There's a whole group of soldiers around him. They've probably been told, don't be nice to this guy. You can do whatever you want to this guy. If you want to hurt him, knock yourself out. We just want him to be humiliated. I'm sure the Pharisees and Sadducees set up this whole arena of thought that, man, I want this guy to feel the pain that he's been making us feel and the embarrassment that he's been making us feel for the last 3 years. And so the battalion took it serious and they gathered everybody together and they stripped him. They put on a scarlet robe on him as if to mock him as a king. They twisted together a crown of thorns that they put on his head and they put a reed in his hand. And after kneeling before him and acting like he was king, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." And they spit on him and they took the reed and they struck him on his thorn-covered head so that the thorns would sink down into his flesh. And they screamed over and over, "Hail, King of the Jews." And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe, they put his old clothes back on him, and they led him away to be crucified. Now, I don't know about you, but in my life, this ticks me off, man. I don't know. I just gotta be honest. I look at this as a Christian. That's my Savior. And they took him and they abused him and they spit on him and they mocked him and they hurt him. And he was defenseless. He didn't fight back. They were just bullies, and I can't stand a bully. And so as I look at it, it really, really angers me. But then as Christians, I think we have to look at it from a different perspective. And here's the perspective. Are you ready? The perspective that we have to look at it from is that they're not followers of Christ. They're not Christians. They're worldly people and lost people. People who don't know Jesus, that are lost from his salvation, lost people act lost. If you go to a baseball game, how do people at the baseball game act? Like people who are baseball fans. If you go to a football game and somebody's playing football, what are they doing? They're wearing the uniform because they are a football player. And as a Christian, if you go to church, you see people acting churchy. Why? Because they have been taught to act churchy. When Jesus comes into our life, he makes us a new creation. The old is gone, the new has come. No longer are we the same, we are different people. He changes us. When he has not changed us, when the world has been all that we know, guess what we're gonna look like? We're gonna look like the world. And when we're introduced to God, it's gonna be a foreign agent in our life. You ever had a foreign substance in your finger like a splinter? You ever had a piece of glass maybe under your skin? You want that out of your skin or whatever it is as fast as you can get it gone because it rubs you, it hurts you, it grinds against your nerves and you're like, oh, I gotta get that out. People who are lost, the Bible says, we are like the aroma of death to them. That we smell bad. We're disgusting to them. They don't understand why we are like we are. That Jesus is the actual aroma of death. So when they're experiencing God in this moment, they're experiencing death. He's the antithesis of everything that they want to be about. And they don't want to be around him. So what do we learn from this scripture in the season of Easter? I think for me, I don't need to get mad at people who hurt Jesus because they don't understand him. Instead, you know what I need to do? I need to be challenged by them. I need to be challenged to be more for them. I need to be motivated to go lead them to him, to give them the truth that they need so they don't mock him anymore, so that they don't spit on him. I don't need to defend him. Jesus doesn't need a defender. Jesus doesn't need me to stand up to the bullies and beat them up for him. God needs me to lead them to him so that they will know the same truth that I do. This Easter, there's gonna be a lot of people in this world who don't need God because they don't understand God. They're gonna mock Easter. What if we were challenged as Christians to go get them. To not be offended by them, but to be challenged by them. To be challenged to let them know the truth that has set us free already. We have that opportunity. I got a challenge for you that I'm also going to put out to the rest of the church. Are you ready? Share Jesus 2020. We are in a weird year. Coronavirus has taken over. We're going to have Easter in our homes for the very first time. And what if we got on Facebook, we got on our social media platform, whatever it is, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, I don't care what it is, and we went on there and we challenged people to share, or we challenged people, let me rephrase that, I challenged myself to share with people that they ought to come and be a part of my church, my service that is at my church online on Sunday morning. Share Jesus. Man, some of you, for years you've been going, I would love to tell people about Jesus, but I don't know how. This is it right here. You can challenge people to come and sit on their couch while you sit on your couch. And what if they heard truth that no longer was the aroma of death to them, but it was the smell of life? And they came to know Jesus because you introduced them to him. Man, what an awesome, awesome opportunity that we have right now to share Jesus in 2020. To those right now who don't have him. My challenge to you this week, don't be offended by people who don't understand. Don't be upset by people who mock your Savior. God does not need a protector. Be challenged by them. Be motivated to lead them to know the truth that you already do. And that is that Jesus can save their life if they'll let him. And then pray, pray, pray. That he changes them, because God has the power to do it. And it's not about whether or not they're mean to him. This moment in which they mocked him and put crown of thorns on his head and beat him down into his skin, Jesus is bigger than that. He overcame the world. He rose from the dead. This was a small moment for Jesus. Sometimes we make it a big one, don't we? But to Jesus, they're small moments. And he knows that those people that do that, they need him. And we need to be the voice that leads them to his feet. Have an awesome day. I'll see you tomorrow for our last Devo of the week.